Hello everyone, welcome to Kernel Playground. Today I want to show you how to create EFI folder for Hackintosh that works for every Mac starting from Mavericks. All you need is access to a macOS, OpenCore GenX tool to create EFI folder, and OpenCore to configure the EFI folder, and active internet connection is needed to update the Kexts files. Let's begin. Open GenX tool and select a system type. My case Haswell. Go to Kexts and keep selected Lilu and virtual SMC. Go to plugins. Select SMC processor and SMC super IO. If you are creating this for a laptop, you can enable SMC light sensor and SMC battery manager. In my case, I have a desktop, so I am just ignoring this. Go to graphics and enable whatever green. Here, make sure AGPM injector is for dedicated graphic card users. In my case, I use inbuilt Intel HD graphics. I am ignoring this. Go to audio and enable Apple ALC. This enables onboard audio for Intel machine. Select Ethernet tab and enable Realtek. Go to USB and enable USB inject all. In my case, I don't have any Wi-Fi and Bluetooth configuration on my board, and I just ignore the extras also. Go to drivers and keep both EFI files as selected. I will ignore SMBIOS for now and configure later. There is no additional boot arguments. So now click on generate. You can see EFI folder is created on desktop. Now I am going to close this and let's open the EFI folder. So here you can see boot and OpenCore folders. Let's update the contents of EFI folder. To do that, open browser and type OpenCore GitHub. Select the first link. You can see OpenCore package in GitHub. Go to releases. Download the most latest OpenCore package. Then search for Hackintosh Kexts and select OpenCore installation guide. Here you can go and select Kexts. Here you can see some of the Kexts are required. So I am going to download all required Kexts files. Start with Lilu and virtual SMC. And whatever green. Apple ALC. Also Realtek. This article having lot of information about different Kexts files for different CPU configurations. Comment below if you have any concerns on that. Let's go to the each tab and download the latest Kexts files. In the download folder, you can see all the Kexts files we downloaded. I'm going to create a new folder and name it as Kexts. And moving Kexts files from downloads to the folder we created. We are good with Kexts files. Let's focus on OpenCore package. I'm expanding the OpenCore package and expanding x64. In that you can see EFI folder, expand it. Here you can see boot. Copy this from here to the EFI folder on the desktop. After that, copy OpenCore EFI file from here to the EFI folder on the desktop. After that, select Tools, copy the clean NVRAM EFI file from here to Desktop EFI Tools folder. Open drivers, select Open HFS Plus, reset NVRAM entry, and Open Runtime EFI files. Copy them. Remove existing EFI files from drivers folder and copy the new files. We need another driver file, which is ApfsDriverLoader. I created one drive link. You will find the link in the description. Open the link and download the file. Once file got downloaded, copy the files into drivers folder. Next step is update ACPI files. To do that, go to Docs, expand ACPI samples. In that, binaries. Here you can see multiple SHTT binaries. Among those, I will select these required SHTTs for my CPU, copy them to ACPI folder in EFI, go to Kexts folder. So we already created a Kexts folder with the latest Kexts. So copy the contents of the newly created Kexts into the EFI folder. Replace the all files. So the Kexts also ready. Let's open the config plist in OpenCore Configurator. This is the time to configure our plist. Here I am selecting ACPI and click on Browse and select SHDTs from EFI folder. So here I am going to ACPI and selecting the existing files and open. Go to Booter. Here we no need to do anything. Let's select device properties. Click on list of PCI devices, add VGA. And here you can see the device type is not required. I am deleting model also not required. In the slot name, change the contents of this with 03002020D. In my case, Intel HD 4600 graphics will work with this value. I found this in Dortania installation guide. You will find that in the video description. Let's go to kernel. Here you can change the architecture to any, to all files, and change the schema architecture also auto. Come to miscellaneous. Select Tools and Scan. Go to EFI folder and select Tools and select Clean NVRAM and enable auxiliary and full NVRAM access. Select Security and disable Secure Boot Model. Go to Serial, change PCI device info to FF. Go to NVRAM and select the third item, delete the existing boot arguments and add ALCID 11. It works for my onboard audio. I found this in the installation guide. If any questions, you also find out in the installation guide, which is added in the video description. Here I am deleting the pre-configured language option because by default it is configured as Russian for Hackintosh. If we delete it, we will get default language as English. Let's go to platform info and here I am going and selecting a system model which is nearly match with my current CPU configuration. I will go with iMac 14,3 because this matches with my CPU configuration. So it will automatically update if we have an active internet connection. Don't forget to check on add this section in config playlist. Go to memory. Change the type detail to 4 and select unknown options. Here we can set it as 0 and maximum capacity also we can set it as 0. Also here we can select unknown and the error correction is none only and data width also 0. Select data hub and check the add section in config plist in both places. That's all in this section. Click on UEFI. We no need to touch anything but except the drivers. So here I am deleting existing EFI files and scanning for new files which is available in EFI folder. Here we can come to drivers and select all these files and add it here. Other than that, we no need to do anything in this section. So we can simply go and save the settings. EFI folder is ready to use. In the next video, we will see how to install OS X Mavericks on Intel machine. Like the video and comment if any feedback or questions. And don't forget to subscribe. Thanks and see you on next video.